welcome to your English class. Dear students, today we are going to continue with the explanation of lesson 4, 5 children and it. Dear students, this is my third video of this lesson. So, open your books on page number 36. As we have discussed in our early videos that 5 children along with their parents came to the countryside and they were, as their parents left them alone in the care of Martha, they started feeling bored. So they decided to go on beach one day and there they found a sand fairy. Jane wished the sand fairy that they want to be beautiful and young, they want to grow up beautiful. So the sand fairy granted their wish. Only the 4 children who were awake, they changed their real images and became grown up. But the youngest of them all, who was known as Lamb, he was still a baby at that time. So when they took the baby in their hands and they tried to go back to their home, firstly Lamb did not recognize his own brothers and sisters. Somehow they managed to reach home with that baby, but when they reached the gate of their home, Martha, who used to look after them, she did not recognize them. She snatched the baby from them and then she asked them that who they were and what they were doing with their baby. "Where us?" said Robert. "I'm Robert." "And I'm Cyril," said Cyril. "Let us in. Please, we know we look different, but big and empty." Now what is being said here is that when Martha demanded that who they were and what they were doing with their baby, Robert said that we are us. He tried to explain Martha that they were the 5 children, they were the 4 of them who came to her and whom she used to look after, but she did not recognize Robert. Cyril also tried to explain her that she is Cyril, but Martha did not recognize her too. Anthea started pleading her. She tried to explain her that they are looking different, but still they are the 4 kids whom she was supposed to look after. "I don't know who you lot are or what you are up to," snapped Martha. "But if our children put you up to this, they'll be in trouble. Shoo!" She shut the door in their faces. Here it has been said that Martha told the children who had grown up at that moment, she told the children that she don't know that who they are and what they were saying, but if the children whom she was supposed to look after, if they had told them to do so, they would be in great trouble. She warned them and then she shut the door on their faces. The children banged at the door and rang the bell, but it was no good. They wandered away down the lane, hungry, thirsty and stunningly beautiful. Finally, tired and with nowhere to go, they sat down under a hedge. Here in this paragraph, it has been told that the children tried to make Martha agree and try to explain her, but she did not listen. She closed the door, due to which they were continuously ringing and banging the door so that she could open it, but she didn't let them in. They wandered down the lane and then they reached the bridge. They reached the hedge and they finally sat under the hedge. They were hungry at that moment, thirsty, and they were looking stunningly beautiful at that time. "It will wear off at sunset," said Jane. "Then we'll look normal again." Then, huddled together for comfort, they fell asleep. When Anthea awoke, the sun had set. "It's all right," she cried. "We are ordinary again." Jane they should grow up, Jane told them that this magic will end, this will disappear, this magic will disappear when and we will become normal again after the sunset. Then they all got together and sat comfortably and fell asleep. When Anthea got up, she saw that the sun had already set. She cried that they were ordinary again. She told the others, she tried to woke them up and she told them that they are back to their normal age now. Where do you think you've been? Demanded Martha when they got home. We had some very strange children here this afternoon. They were horrible, said Anthea. They stopped us from coming home until now. We only just got away and we are starving. Well, don't you go near them again, said Martha. As cook brought in a supper that looked and smelled delicious, we'll take good care to never see them again, said Forward, and then never have. Here it is being said that when they reached home, Martha asked them that where they had been all this time, and she also told them that some very strange children came to their home that afternoon. Anthea said that pretending that she had also met those children, she said that those children were horrible, and she told Martha that those children stopped them from coming home till now, and somehow they have managed to come back to their homes. And she also told Martha that they were starving with hunger. Well, Martha warned the children that they should never meet those children again. And just then the cook brought in supper, which looked very delicious and smelled good. The children agreed to this, and Robert said that they will take care and they will never meet those children again. Dear students, this lesson is an extract from the 5 children and it's by